good morning everyone. Today's topic of the engineering material is composite material. So actually, what is the composite material? A composite material is a material system composed of the two or more micro constituents that differ in the shape and the chemical composition, which are insoluble in each other. A composite is the present environment, is the multi-phase material that is the artificially made as the opposed to one that occurs to form naturally. The history of the composite material dates back to earlier 20th century. In 1940, the fiberglass was first used to reinforce epoxy. The epoxy is the one of the layer of the fiber on the glass. Composite of the sorts that have already been discussed. These includes the multi-phase metal alloys in the previous lectures, ceramics and the polymers. For example, the paralytic steel have a microstructure consists of the alternative layers of the alpha ferrite and the cementite. The ferrite phase is soft and ductile, whereas the cementite is hard and very brittle. The applications of the composite material in the various fields, that is aero space industries, sporting goods industries, automotive industries, home appliances, etc. Where the composite materials are used, here we see the two types of the composite material, carbon fiber reinforced composite, and the second one is glass fiber reinforced composite. The carbon fiber reinforced composite is used in the tires of the aerospace and the tires of the vehicles, and the glass fiber reinforced composite is used in the body of the automobiles and other sectors. Engineering applications of the composite material is in the aerospace, is already told, automobiles, pressure vessels and the pipes. The aerospace generally used as a blade of the helicopters and the tires of the aeroplanes or the helicopters, and in automobiles, as we see in the glass fiber reinforced composite, it is used in the make the body of the automobiles. Pressure vessels and pipe, where the high pressure fluid is flow in the pipe, that type of pipe or pressure vessels is used with the composite material. In the diagram you see the turbine blades, wind turbine blades made with the composite material. Here it is the turret shield that is used in the war, industrial spring which is already used in automobiles and other fields, and medical tables and bulletproof shields. The advantage of the composite materials are that the high strength to weight ratio, that is the low density, high tensile strength or high specific strength ratio. 1020 hot rolls steel, specific resistance strength is 1. And the ratio of graphite and the epoxy specific strength is 5. High creep resistance, high tensile strength at the elevated temperature, high toughness also generally perform the better than the steel or the aluminium in the applications where the cyclic loads are encountered, leading to potential fatigue failures, for example in helicopter's blades. Impact load or the vibrations, composite can be specially performed with high toughness and the high damping to reduce the load inputs. Some composites have much higher wear resistance than the metals. Corrosion resistance is one of the properties in the composite material. Dimensional change due to the temperature change can be less. Anisotropy, bidirectional properties can be design advantage, which is already discussed in helicopter blades. Now the some disadvantage or the limitations of the composite material is material cost is very high because the composition of the different material and the processing is very expensive. Fabrication and the manufacturing difficulties, repairs can be difficult, wider range of the varieties are available. Operating temperature can be issued for the polymer matrix, that is the 260 degree centigrade, less as issue the matter matrix is 1452 degree centigrade approximately. Properties non-isotropic makes design difficult and inspection and testing typical more complex. The terminology and the classification of the composite material. The composite is already discussed, the multi-phase material with significant proportional to each phase, that is generally divided into the two, the matrix and the dispersed phase, and the matrix is again classified into the metal, metal matrix ceramic, MMC, metal matrix ceramic, sorry, composite, ceramics, metal composite, polymer, matrix composite. The, its properties is the continue phase and the transverse stress, and the purpose to use it to transfer the stress to the other phase, protect phase from the environment, and the dispersed phase purpose to enhance the matrix properties. MMC increase the yield strength, tensile strength and grip resistance, and the CMC increase the bulk modulus, PMC increase the Young's modulus or the modulus of elasticity, yield strength and tensile strength and grip resistance. The classification of this dispersed phase is particle, fibers and structure. So here we see the first diagram is the fibers, which is the woolens, which are the cross to each other, but in this diagram this is the sectional view of these fibers. Systematic representation of the various geometrical and the spectral characteristics of the particles of the dispersed phase that may be influence the properties of composite. The first here we see the concentration of the dispersed phase. Here it is the concentration of the dispersed phase in the blue color, that is the matrix phase, and the in orange cylindrical shape is the dispersed phase. This shows the concentration in the composite. Second is the size of the composite. Here we see the diameter of the rod is less than the these diameters, and the third diagram is different in shapes. Here we see the cylindrical shape in upper part and the rectangular plate, rectangular bars in second part. And here the rearrangement of the these bars, that is the distribution, and in the last there is the orientation. So here it is in horizontal position and this is in vertical position. Therefore the orientation will be changed. This is the classification of the composite materials. Generally it is classified into the three: particle reinforced, fiber reinforced and the structural. The particle reinforced is further classified into the large particle, dispersion strength, and the fiber reinforced are further classified into continuous, which is called allied, and discontinuum, which is called short. Discontinuum is again classified into allied and randomly oriented. And the structural is divided into the laminates and the sandwich panels. So firstly we discuss about the large particle composites. In the term large is used to indicate the particle matrix. Interaction cannot be treated on the atomic or the molecular level. Rather, continuum mechanism is used for the most of these composites. The particulate phase is the harder and the stiffer than the matrix. Another familiar large particle composite is concrete, which is composed of the cements, that is called the matrix, and the sand and gravel, that is called the particulates. The large particles are the utilized with all three materials type, like the metal, polymers and the ceramics. Thus cements are the example of the ceramic metal composite. The most common cements is the cemented carbide, which is the composed of the extremely hard particle of the refractories, carbide ceramics such as the tungsten carbides, titanium carbides, embedded to the matrix of the metal such as the cobalt and nickel. When the added to the vulcanized rubber, this is extremely inexpensive material, enhance the tensile strength, toughness and tear and abrasion resistance. Automobile tires contains on order of 15 to 30% of carbon black. Rules of the mixture of equations for the two-phase composite: modulus of elasticity for the upper bound expression, and here it is the summation of the elasticity modulus and the volume fraction. This is the product of the modulus of elasticity and volume fraction for the matrix and for the particulars. So it is the summation of the matrix and the particulars, elastic modulus and the volume fraction. For the two-phase composite, the modulus of elasticity for the lower bound expression, that is the ratio of EM EP plus VM EP plus VP EM. So here again the E is the modulus of elasticity and V is the volume fraction, and P denotes the particular, M denotes the matrix, and C denotes the composites. This is the graph between the modulus of elasticity versus the volume percentage of tungsten for a composite of the tungsten particle dispersed within a copper matrix. Upper and the lower bond, upper bond and this is the lower bond, are according to the equation as we see in the previous slide. The experimental data points are the includes. These are the curve for these observations. So here it is the curve between the modulus of elasticity and tugstrain concentration in terms of volume percentage, and red line shows the upper bound and lower line, blue line shows the lower bound, and here it is the experimental observations of the volume percentage according to the tungsten concentration. Now the concrete. The concrete is the common large particle composite in which both matrix and the dispersed phase are the ceramic material. Since the term concrete and the cements are the sometimes incorrectly interchanged, perhaps it is appropriate to make the distinct between them. In broadly sense, the concrete implies the composite material consists of an aggregate of the particle that are the bonded bound together in the solid body of the some type of binding medium, that is the cement. And the two most familiar concrete are those made by the Portland cement and the asphaltic cement, where the aggregates is the gravels and sands. Portland cement concrete is ingredients for these concrete. For the Portland cement, a fine aggregate, that is sand, and the coarse aggregate, that is gravel and water. The process by which the Portland cement is produced and the mechanism of the setting and hardening. The reinforced concrete. The steel serves as the suitable reinforcement material because it is the coefficient of the thermal expansion is nearly the same as that of the concrete, which are used for the highway and railway bridges. Now the second is dispersion strength composites. The metal and the metal alloy may be the strengthened and hardened by the uniform dispersion of the thermal volume percentage of the fine particle of the very hard and the inert material. The dispersed phase may be the metallic or non-metallic. Oxide material are often used. Again, the strengthening mechanism involves interaction between the particles and the dislocation within the matrix as with the precipitation hardening. The dispersion strength effect is not a pronounced as with the passive precipitation hardening. However, the strengthening is retained at the elevated temperature and for the extended time period because the dispersed particles are chosen to the in reactive with the matrix phase. For the precipitation hardening alloy, it increase the strength may be disappear upon the heat treatment as a consequence of the precipitate growth or the dissolution of the precipitate phase. A very thin and the inherent alumina coated is caused to form on the surface of extremely small, that is 0.1 to 0.2 millimeter thick, the flakes of the aluminium which is dispersed within the aluminium metal matrix. This material is termed as the sanitary aluminium powder. In short, we say SAP. Fiber reinforced composite. The technological, the most important composite are those in which the dispersed phase is in the form of fiber. The design goal. Reinforced composite often include the high strength and the stiffness of the weight basic. These characteristics are the expressed in terms of the specific strength and specific modulus parameters, which correspond respectively to the ratio of the tensile strength to the specific gravity and modulus of elasticity to the specific gravity. The fiber reinforced composite with expectationally high specific strength and the moduli have been produced that utilize low density fiber and the matrix material. Influence of the fiber length. The mechanical characteristics of the fiber reinforced composite depend only on the properties of the fiber but also on the degree to which applied the load in the transmitted to the fiber by the metric phase. So here it is the length of the composite and sigma fd and by 2 tau c. Here the sigma f is the ultimate tensile strength and the tau c represent the fiber matrix bond strength and d is the diameter of the fiber. The deformation pattern in the matrix surrounding a fiber that is subjected to the applicant tensile load. Here it is the object. So this is shows the matrix and this is the fiber. And here we apply the tensile load on both sides of the rod and we see this is the initial position of the matrix fiber and when we apply the load it is the twist against the load. So this is the condition when we apply it subjected to the tensile load on the matrix and the fiber rod. As the fiber length increase, the fiber reinforcement become the more effective and this is the demonstrated in the figure in the next slide. A stress axial position profile for the L is greater than LC where the applied stress is equal to the fiber strength and the figure C shows the stress position profile for the L is less than the LC and the fiber force, the fiber for which L is more greater than the LC, normally it is 15 times greater than LC. Are the term continue and discontinue or the short fiber that length shorter that is this discontinue fiber of the length significant less than LC. So this is shown by this figure the stress position profile where the fiber length and A diagram is show is equals to the this is the critical length is equals to the original length, L is equals to LC and the graph will be like that. The maximum load is applied on that and there is a no change in the length of the fiber and this is the maximum stress on that fiber in the mid position and in second figure when we apply the more load on tensile load on the this bar and we see the capital L is greater than LC and that is the original length is greater than critical length. Okay, now when we apply the compressive load on the fiber and we see the this is the maximum position of the stress and here we see the stress will be reduced in this bar and this time small L is less than to the LC. Influence of the fiber orientation and the concentration. This is continuing fiber and composite. The tensile strength, tensile behavior of the longitudinal loading. And this is the systematic representation of first we see the continue and the align and second is discontinue and the align and third is for the discontinue and the randomly oriented fiber reinforcement composite. In this we see the longitudinal direction, the force is firstly applied in the longitudinal direction then after in second condition we apply the load in transverse direction. So here we see the fibers are the continue and the aligned system. And in the second B diagram, when we applied the longitudinal direction load and after that the transverse load, the discontinue and the aligned fibers are shown. And in the third diagram, this is in the randomly oriented fibers and discontinue type of fibers. Systematic stress strength curve for the brittle fiber. This is for the this is the brittle fiber and this is the ductile matrix material, and the fracture stress and strain for both the material are noted. And the second is systematic stress strain curve for the aligned fiber reinforcement composite. It exposed the unit axial stress and applied the directional of the alignment curve for the fiber matrix and the material shown by a part is also superimposed. So here in this diagram, this is the curve between the stress strain and this is the brittle fiber and this is the ductile matrix. So when we increase the stress, it is the maximum position of the stress and this is the fracture stress. And here we see this is the fracture when we strain is stress will be in the medium position, mean position, then this is the fracture position. And in between the fiber and the matrix, here it is the composite we see between the fiber and matrix. So this green color shows the composite, and you see this is the composite stress, and this is the failure point, and this is the difference in the strain here we see. For continue and the aligned fiber reinforced composite, modulus of elasticity in the longitudinal direction as we see in the previous slide. Here it is the ECL is equals to the volume fraction weighted average to the modulus of the elasticity of the matrix and the fiber phase. The M stands for the matrix phase and F is for the fiber phase. And here we see by the Hooke's law, the stress upon strain is equal to the modulus of elasticity. So this is for the composite, this is for the matrix, and this is for the phase. The composite consists only the matrix of the fiber phase, that is by this formula Vm plus Vf equal to 1. Now put the value of Vm. So here this is 1 minus Vf. So put here the value of Vm. The now the equation becomes ECL and equal to Em 1 minus Vf plus Ef Vf. The longitudinal load, that the ratio of the load carried by the fiber, that is carried by the matrix, is by the Ff and the Fm. Ff is the force on the fiber and Fm is the force on the matrix, and it is again denoted by the Ef Vf upon Em Vm. This is the numerical problem based on the previous formulas. A continue and the aligned glass fiber composite consists of the 40% volume of the glass fiber having the modulus of elasticity of 69 GPa and 60% volume of the polyester resin when the harder display a modulus of 3.4 GPa. The first, the compute the modulus of elasticity is composite in the longitudinal direction. So here we see in the previous slide, so this formula is used to calculate the value of elasticity of the composite, modulus of elasticity of composite. put the value of EM, VM and EF, VF and calculate the value of ECL. In the second part, to solve the portion of the problem, the first find the ratio of the fiber load, the matrix load, as we see already see the formula, and calculate this value of the ratio of the load, and this is the value of composite load by the formula AC sigma, and this value is area of composite is given and the stress value is given in the question, and this is the total load VFF plus FM. So here it is, FC value is already calculated, then this is the FC value, and by this equation we calculate the value of FM, and now put the value of FM and FC in this formula and calculate the value of FF. Now in third part, the stress for both the fiber and the matrix face must first be calculated, that using the elastic of modulus for each the strain value may be determined. So here it is the area of matrix and here it is the area of face, and this is the stress of matrix and this is the stress of face, and here it is we calculate finally the strain value of matrix and strain value of face. Now the modulus of elasticity in the transverse direction, by this formula we calculate the value of modulus of elasticity in the transverse direction. In the previous problem, put the value, all the values of EM, EF, BM, EF and all these values and calculate the value of modulus of elasticity in the transverse direction. Now the polymer matrix composite. The polymer matrix composite consists of the polymerism 1 as the matrix with the fiber as the reinforcement medium. The glass fiber reinforcement polymer composite, the fiber diameter is normally range between the 3 to 20 micrometer. The glass is properly popular as the fiber reinforcement material for the several reasons. It is easily drawn into the high strength fiber from the molten state. It is readily available and may be the fiber into the glass reinforced plastic economically used as a wider variety of composite manufacturing techniques. As the fiber is relatively strong when embedded in the plastic matrix, it is produced a composite have a very high specific strength. When the coupled with the various plastics, it process a chemical inertness that renders the composite useful in the varieties of the corrosive environment. Carbon fiber reinforcement polymers composites, the carbon is the high performance material that is most commonly used in reinforcement in advanced polymer matrix composite. The reason are that the carbon fibers have the highest specific modulus and the specific strength of all the reinforcing fiber material. At the room temperature, carbon fibers are not affected by the moisture or the wide variety of solvent, acid and base. Fibers and the composite manufacturing process have been developed that is the relatively inexpensive and cost effective. The composite survey of the particle first, the particle reinforcement, these are the example, the spheroid is steel, so here it is the alpha ferrite which is in ductile in nature, which is shown by the white color, and the particles of the cementite which is in brittle in nature by show by these circles. And here the second one is the cemented carbide. The matrix cobalt is shown by in white in color, and particle of the tungsten carbide, which is brittle in nature, show by these structures. And the volume of the cobalt is used 5 to 12%. And automobile tire, these are the rubber resin, and these black color are the carbon resin, which is stiffer in nature. Composite survey particle 2, for the particle reinforcement concrete, and pre-stress concrete. Concrete, as we already discussed, the gravel sands and the cements, reinforcement concrete, the reinforced with the steel bars and remesh, which increase the strength. Pre-stress concrete, remesh under the tension during the setting of the concrete. The tension release put the concrete under the compressive force. The post tensioning, here we see the tighten the nut in both the end of the rod and to which is in the concrete under the compressive load. Now the second is fiber reinforcement. The fiber tensions are the very strong, provide the significant strength, improve the material. For example, the fiberglass, the continuous glass filament in the polymer matrix, strength due to the fiber. Polymer simply hold them in the place and the environmental protect them. This is the example of the fiber material, viscous, thin type or thin crystal structure, large length of the diameter ratio. For example, graphite, silicon nitride, silicon carbide, high critical perfection and very expensive. The fibers, the polycrystal or the amorphosis, generally polymers or the ceramics, for example, aluminium oxide, aramids, e-glass and the boron. And the wires, metal, steel, molybdenum and tungsten. The extract and the third you take for the structure, the extract and the bonded fiber reinforcement sheet, the stacking sequence is 0 degree, then 90 degree and 0 degree, 45 degree, 90 degree. Benefit, balance in the plane stiffness. So here we see these are the different categories of the sheet and is combined and in the form of the compact sheet. And in the form of the bonded fiber reinforcement sheet. The sandwich panel, here we see the low density, honeycomb core, benefit, the lightweight, large benefit strips. So these are the face sheet, this is the adhesive sheet and this is the honeycomb, and it forms the fabricated sandwich panel. This is the binding of the filament. Filament binding, for example, it is used in the pressure tanks. Continuously filament bonded onto the mantle. This is the helical binding, this is the circumferential binding, and this is the polar binding. Filament binding characteristics, because of the tension, retent, the shape cannot be produced. CNC binding machine with server degree of freedom are the frequently employed. The filaments in the either the pre-coated with the polymers is drawn through a polymer bar so that they pick up the polymer on the way of the winder. While the volume can be higher, the cost is about the half of the tape laying and productivity is also high, that is the 50 kg per hour. The fibers pulse fusion, the fibers are the saturated with the pre-polymer exactly the position with the guide and the preheated and pulled through the heated and taping die where the curing take place. Here we see this is the coated fiber and this is the forming guide, and here it is the preheated of these form coated fiber, and it is passes through the heated die, and this is in the form of the reinforcement composite, and now it is cooled and then the pull by the pulleys, and then the cut the fibers in required length. Composite production method, this is pulverization. This is one of the another method. This is the fiber rolling, and this is the resin impregnation tag, and this is performing tie, and this is curing tie, and this is puller. So here it is the continuing fiber is pulled through the resin tag, then performing the die over the cure. The production rate is around the 1 meter per minute. The applications of the sorting goods: golf club shaft, vehicle drive shaft, because of the high dynamic capacity, and the non-conductive ladder rails for the electric service, and the structural member for the vehicles and the aerospace applications. This is the pre-pack production process. In this, the pre-pack is the composite industry terms for the continuing fiber reinforcement pre-pregnated with the polymer resin, then it is into the particular curing. The pre-pack is the delivered into the tape form to the manufacturer, who then the mold and the fully cure the produce without having the add any resin. So this is the composite form most widely used in the structural application. So here we see these are the spooled fiber, and here it is the spooled pre-pack, and this is the carrier paper. These three are the mixed here, and this is the waste release paper, and this is the heated resin by the hopper containing, and this is the doctor blade which maintain the thickness of the fiber, and this is the again the release paper. So this is the combination of the spooled fiber and paper and the spooled prepacks. The summary of this lecture is: composites are the classified according to the matrix material, reinforcement geometry particle. Composite enhance the matrix properties, that is the tensile strength, bulk modulus, yield strength, modulus of elasticity. Particular reinforced, that is the elastic modulus, can be estimated properties of the anisotropy. The fiber reinforcement, the elastic modulus of tensile strength can be estimated along the direction, and the structure based on the build up the sandwich in the layered form. Thank you very much.